Now I'm going to go over how you can kind of add a second Gmail account to your Google Assistant. So basically what this will do is you'll add a secondary account to your Google Assistant. So when you ask it what's on your calendar, it will read what's from the main account you have and the secondary account we're about to go and add. It is mostly just for calendar stuff. It doesn't do too much else, but if you have a work email or something like that that you can use with this, that might be kind of useful, because that way you don't have to have all this other stuff tied to your work account. You can do it under a separate one, but still be able to have the Google Assistant read off those calendar events. So to go ahead and do this, you want to jump into the Google Assistant settings. So I'm going to do it from the Google Home app here. And I'm going to tap on my user in the top right, then select user or assistant settings. From here, you want to scroll down to where you see accounts. And this works on Android or iOS as long as you're using the Home app. When you get to this screen, you may see emails that are already on your phone down here, and you just have to click enable. If not, select add a new account. You want to type in the new account, email, and the password, your secondary Gmail account. Then once you're here, you want to go ahead and select, yes, I'm in. You can read over the terms of service and then select, I agree. And there you go. You can see here is that second account. And if for some reason you add the new account and it doesn't load here right away, if you just jump back and jump back in, it'll pop up. It just needs to manually refresh there. If I select enable account, it says enable this account will allow the assistant to access data and services provided by this account. For example, your Google Calendar and Google Meet. So it also will work with Google Meets too, as well as the calendar. We're gonna tap continue. There we go. So now you can see the services that are enabled are Google Calendar and Google Meets. And then down here, you want to go ahead and select the Nest Home or Google Home devices that you want to enable these personal results for this secondary account. So if I check the office speaker, and you can check whichever ones you want, you can do all of them or just a few of them. Once I do that, you'll see you'll get this little pencil icon, this edit icon. If we select that, we get even more options. So you have two options, which are show proactively or don't show proactively. So if we leave it on show proactively, anyone with access to that device can see and interact with your personal results. If face match is enabled for your main account, so if you have a Nest Home or Nest Hub Max, face match will work. Personal results will only show when the assistant recognizes your face. So that's only for the Nest Hub Max. Right now it's the only one with a camera on it. Or you can say don't show proactively. Only show your personal results when you ask for them. And I'm gonna leave it on that one just to have a little bit more privacy if you want. So that again is up to you. It depends on how you wanna leave it. So I'm gonna tap save. And you can do that for each one of the speakers that you check. But that's how you go ahead and add a second account to your Google Assistant in the Assistant settings. That way you can get Calendar and Google Meets events on your different Nest Home or Google Home devices. Hopefully that video helps. And if it does, go ahead and leave a like down below and subscribe to the channel to get more videos like this on how to make your technology work better for you. Thanks.